Welcome to part one of the general chemistry review for organic chemistry. I'm Melissa Maribel, your personal tutor, and let's start with valence electrons. Valence electrons are the electrons on the outermost shell of an atom that are either gained or lost during a chemical reaction. These are the valence electrons you will need to have memorized. First group has one valence electron, second group has two. We skip the transition metals since they vary, and now this group has 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and the noble gases have 8 valence electrons. We can transfer electrons, which describes an ionic bond. And we can share electrons, which describes a covalent bond, which is what you have normally seen for Lewis structures. Remember, 2 electrons form one single bond, 4 electrons form a double bond, and 6 electrons form a triple bond. Say we wanted to draw the Lewis structure for CH4. First, we'd identify how many valence electrons we have. Carbon has 4, hydrogen has 1, multiplied by 4 since there is a 4 subscript. Add everything together and we have 8 total valence electrons. If carbon is in your molecule, then carbon is the central atom. This is also due to hydrogen only being able to make one bond due to it only having one valence electron. So we'll place carbon in the center, surrounded by its 4 valence electrons, and place the 4 hydrogens with one valence electron on each hydrogen. We stated that 2 valence electrons form one single bond, so this is our correct Lewis structure. And you know, you could have just drawn the single bonds first instead of drawing each valence electron since the atoms have to bond regardless for Lewis structures. Onto 5 different Lewis structures you'll see in organic chemistry. Here's the first one. We'll identify the total valence electrons in the structure. Carbon has 4 valence electrons times 2, so 8. Hydrogen has 1 valence electron times 6, so 6. 8 plus 6 is 14 valence electrons. Both carbons will be our central atoms, and each will be surrounded by 3 hydrogens. Everything is bonded together, so we'll place our single bond and count up all the valence electrons to make sure we have 14 total. Remember, each single bond counts as 2 electrons, so 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Check. You also know this structure is correct because it obeys the octet rule, which states that an atom wants to have 8 valence electrons, and for carbon, it must obey the octet rule. Here's our second structure. Identify the total valence electrons. Carbon has 4 times 2, so 8. Hydrogen has 1 times 4, so 4. 8 plus 4 is 12 valence electrons. The carbons are central atoms surrounded by 2 hydrogens on each side. For now, we will place single bonds, and if we count up all the valence electrons, we only have 10, but we need 12. You typically won't see carbon with any lone pairs. You instead will see carbon with a higher bond, meaning a double or triple bond. Since we only need 2 more electrons, we will turn this single bond into a double bond, and this obeys the octet rule since each carbon has 4 bonds, which is really 8 valence electrons. Here's the third structure. Identify the total valence electrons. Carbon has 4 times 2, so 8. Hydrogen has 1 times 2, so 2. 8 plus 2 gives us 10 valence electrons. The carbons are central atoms surrounded by 1 hydrogen on either side. Place single bonds and we only have 6 valence electrons, but we need 10. So we need 4 more valence electrons. So we'll turn the single bond between the carbons into a triple bond. And now we get 10 valence electrons, and each carbon obeys the octet rule. Note, carbon prefers to have a higher bond versus lone pairs. But for nitrogen and oxygen, these atoms most likely will need lone pairs to follow the octet rule. Here's the fourth structure. Identify the total valence electrons. Carbon has 4, hydrogen has 1 each, and there are 5 total hydrogens, so 5. Nitrogen has 5 valence electrons. 4 plus 5 plus 5 gives us 14 valence electrons. Our central atoms are never hydrogen, therefore carbon and nitrogen must be the central atoms. Now the given chemical formula is telling us how many hydrogens go on each central atom. Carbon gets 3 and nitrogen gets 2. If we count the valence electrons, we get 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, but we need 14 valence electrons. And carbon already has the maximum amount of bonds, which is 4. So one lone pair goes on the nitrogen, and both the carbon and nitrogen now follow the octet rule. Here's our fifth structure. Identify the valence electrons. Carbon has 4, each hydrogen gets 1, so we have 4 hydrogens, so 4. Oxygen has 6, 4 plus 4 plus 6 is 14 valence electrons. Our central atoms are carbon and oxygen. The chemical formula tells us that there are 3 hydrogens surrounding the carbon atom and only 1 hydrogen bonded to the oxygen. Placing our single bonds, we will see that we only have 10 valence electrons and we need 4 more. So oxygen needs 2 lone pairs since carbon already has the maximum amount of bonds. And this is the correct Lewis structure. I've linked up part 2 right over here, which covers polarity and Vesper theory, so make sure to review that because it will come up again. That's it for part 1, and I'll see you in part 2.